All right, I get asked all the time how I get land deals that I net anywhere from 40, 50, 100,000, sometimes six-figure land deals net profit. And I get asked all the time, how do you do it? How do you do it? Well, one thing is we're always getting in front of the landowners, but there's a second piece to that puzzle, and that's having a secret weapon, and that's called a sales trainer. Guys, I want to introduce you to Claude Diamond, my secret weapon, who has basically he's the creator of guts sales training method, and I want to do some role play with Claude today and show you guys how we're getting land deals at massive discounts, and we're turning around and selling these and making a fortune doing it. Sometimes we sell them on seller financing and we get paid every month. Sometimes we sell them for quick cash. Claude, how are you today?
I am great. Thank you for asking, man. Joe Namath used to always say, I can't wait for tomorrow because I get better looking every day. I'm just having a lot of fun with this business. It's too darn addictive. You know, I could have retired a long time ago, and I don't want to. It's too much fun.
Yeah. What's fun about it? Is it just the negotiations with sellers of real estate, or just role playing, or teaching guys like me how to do better real estate deals?
I'm at a point where I just love when my students come back to me and say, Claude, I just had the best financial month of my life. I learned how to give good phone. I'm comfortable on the phone. It's no longer, this phone is no longer a cactus. Okay. And I'm making more money. I'm paying off bills. My wife could quit her job. I can send my kids to the better schools. Just to have that freedom, you know, that your life is short, man.
You just mentioned phone, and for some people, that's just a scary thing. You said like a cactus, so I assume it's like some people just are afraid of phone, right? Afraid of the phone.
Yeah, and that's kind of the problem that we have in our society today. We think we can automate everything, but I got to tell you, I've been doing deals for over 30 years, and I've never done a deal where I haven't spoke to the buyer, the seller, and the investor one-on-one on the phone. Today, I use Zoom a lot, but sooner or later, you have to negotiate the deal. How do you read the person? How do you know their wants and needs? How do you know what pain level they are? How do you know how to get the best price or terms? You can't text. If you text all that stuff all day long, your thumbs are going to break, man.
I mean, you just hit a hot button right there. Just the fact of getting them on Zoom or a FaceTime. I really like FaceTime as well. You get their attention, you get their best
Right.
behavior, and you can see when they kind of twitch or where they're at in the negotiation process. Because I think just getting comfortable with the phone and having skills, negotiation skills, is probably one of the biggest pieces to the puzzle, because you do have to talk to these sellers. You do have to talk to these buyers. And me in the beginning, I was afraid to do it, so I always hired it out. However, when you figure out a way to do it yourself, and I'm not saying do it yourself forever, and some people do that. I mean, I know you've done very well with that, Claude, but
Thank
getting
you.
comfortable with it, getting the practice. So I just wanted to bring kind of just introduce people to Guts a little bit. You've got an amazing book. If you go to gutsrhino.com, you can start checking out Claude's book. But do you want to do a little quick role play on how to talk to sellers?
I love role plays, but I wanted to comment on what you said before. I compare this to a couple different things. One of them is the first one is like when you started driving a car. When you were a teenager and it was real mechanical and you're holding the steering wheel the right way and you're checking your feet and adjusting your mirrors and everything and you're all self-conscious and white knuckle driving. And most people after a while they get in the car, they don't even think about it. We put on our seatbelt automatically, and that's what sales has got to be. Okay, I'm the former world's worst salesman, and today I can talk to peeling the wallpaper for 15 minutes. I love talking to people. And then I do what the most doctors do. I come in and I ask questions. Hey, Brent, how do you feel, man? When did it, what hurts? When did it start hurting? Are you taking any medication? And that's the way you become a gut salesperson and engage people in great conversations. And if you can do that every day, life is, it's fun. Even when you don't make a sale, it's fun. And you get away from all that stigma of being rejected and all that junk. That's why most people don't pick up the phone because they're so scared, they're terrorized of being rejected. And we want to show them that there's a way to make sales fun. Let's do that role play. Yes.
Yeah, fear of failure, fear of rejection. We really only have two fears, and I love
Yeah.
that. All
And
right, so
unnecessary when you have a system.
So let's do a quick role play. I love land. I know you love land too. You have some amazing land investments.
Land has been so good to me. And here's the best part. I'm going to sound like I'm a transplanted New Yorker. No more tenants in turlets.
Yeah, I highly agree with that.
Man,
I
you
don't like the
cannot.
termites
And
either.
I've done a lot of tenants in turlets and fixer uppers, and I love my residential real estate. Okay, I still own a lot, but boy, do I love my land because it goes up in value, and I have no issues with it. It just makes me money.
Well, let's show the audience, the listeners, how to negotiate a land deal. So, you cool with me being the seller? Because I'll let you take it first. I
Sure.
think you're a way better negotiator than
Is it a
I am.
warm call? Is it a warm call or a cold call? Because I got systems for both.
Yeah, it's definitely a warm call. So I reached out to you. I'm calling you. Hey, Claude, I got your letter about my land. What's going
Yeah.
on? I'm getting letters lately. Like, can you tell me about this? What's going on?
I don't know. What do you mean? What letter? I'm sorry.
You sent me a letter, Claude, to buy my land. You don't remember?
Oh, that's what you were talking. Okay, thank you for helping me out. Okay, just off the role play real quick. Sometimes the best thing you can say is acting like you're feigning ignorance, we call it, or saying I don't know. Let the prospect do all the work. Let them sell you. So the first thing I said, who, what? I don't know. Oh, that letter, real estate, boom. So we want to
Yeah,
get an
you threw me
emotional
off
rise
guard.
out of it.
You threw me off guard, and I knew we were doing it, you know?
Yeah.
So I can only imagine with the seller.
What
So.
letter? Oh, that letter. Okay, thank you. I'm so back in the role play. Oh, thank you so much. And your name again? I'm sorry.
Brent Bowers.
Hi, Brent. I'm Claude. So you have something? Oh, great. You got a piece of property you want to sell me today?
Yeah, it's the one on 123 Main Street. It's out in California. You sent me a letter. I thought you might want to buy it.
Yeah, I probably do it. You know what? I'm ready to buy a piece of property today. Tell me why I should buy it from you.
Oh, well, there's building going on everywhere. These builders can't get it fast enough.
You mind if I take notes while you're? Yeah, this is great stuff. You're a gentleman. Thank you so much. Okay, you mind? Thank you for calling me back too. Can I take some notes while you're telling me all this stuff?
Yeah, please, sure. I figured you were familiar with the land. You
This
sent
is
me the letter.
great information. Okay, another quick timeout. Okay, I do a lot of stroking and nurturing. Thank you. You're a gentleman. And then I also take notes, especially if I'm on the phone or on Zoom. Why? Why is taking notes so important?
Because you're making me feel like what I'm saying is important.
Exactly. So much of this is emotional selling.
And you got to
Okay.
remember too, like we all want presence. We all want the attention. My wife was just talking to me right before I walked in and got on this call with you, Claude, and I had other things on my mind, things I wanted to do. I thought about looking at my phone and I said, "No, I'm going to stare her in the eyes and listen to what she's saying." Because and most people don't get that at home, at work. So if you provide that, I already know, or I'm already wanting to like you and trust you, and I want to get to know you.
What you got to ask yourself, what is the psychology of persuasion? What do I need to say to somebody? How do I get another person who I've never met before on the phone, on Zoom, even in person? How do I get that person to respect me, listen to me? How do I get them to know, like, and trust me? There are moves, psychological moves. I've been studying human behavior forever, and I learned everything I needed, I learned from my mentor who could get on the phone. He was so natural. He was so confident. He was so charismatic. And me, I'm a little chicken shit, pardon my language. Okay. And I saw, how do you do that, man? He said, I don't know. I just do it. So I studied all the different aspects of psychology, all the different top psychologists, so that we use the right words, we act in the right framework. We do these and all these little things that you and I are doing in this role play. These are all moves. So the bottom line is, can I just
Guts
get into a nice
moves.
conversation? What's that?
Guts moves.
Guts move, great untraditional, unorthodox techniques of sales. How do I get you in the right frame of mind? And do I close everybody? Of course not. But I close enough people to have a great lifestyle. I mean, a fantastic, I have no employees. I work out of my homes. I am totally debt free. How did I get there? I learned how to give good phone. And that, to me, that's the $1 million skill that nobody, except for you, thank you, and myself, are talking about. And let's go back in the role play here. But I wanted to define these little moves. I don't want to skip over them too much because
No, I like that. And this is, I'm still a student of this. I get to practice with you every week and on your calls and read your books. So that's why I'm excited to introduce this to my Land Sharks community and YouTube and wherever you're watching this. I want to introduce you to my secret weapon here. So let's go back to it. Okay, yeah. So yeah, thanks. Please feel
Oh
free to
yeah.
take notes.
Yeah, so the property, you're the you mind if I ask you a few questions and then you can ask
Sure.
me a few or tell me about the property and then I'll make you an offer today.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Okay. This is quick. I didn't expect all this.
I'm a DQ guy. I do it quick.
Do
I
it
get
quick.
right to it. You're a busy man, so am I, and I really appreciate the, your time calling me today. And then we'll figure out if we want to move forward. And if we can't, can you do me a small favor? Can you fire me today? Just tell me to get lost.
Okay.
I don't bother you, leave voicemails, and you're not going to say I'll think. You don't have to say I'll think about it, or you got to talk to your pet rock or something like that. Okay.
Yeah, I think I can make a decision yes or no today. So no is fire you.
And let's do what's right for you. Let's do what's right for you here. No pressure. Boom.
Okay.
That is called an agenda. And an agenda is so important. Have you ever met a salesperson who told you it's okay to say no or fire you?
Never, never.
Never. Why do I do that? Because why would, what's the logic behind that move?
One, you want to be different, and two, you want to still, it's almost like an authority. I called you, you're the doctor. You're asking the questions, you're in charge, and you're steering the conversation.
Yeah, I'm steering the conversation. I am in control. Even though I'm not maybe acting like I'm in control, I'm acknowledging you, I'm thanking you, I'm complimenting you, I'm setting the rules in advance. Okay, you can't play a good game, you can't have a boxing match or a baseball game without some rules up front, right? So let's
Exactly.
be. This is this goes back to Dr. Eric Byrne. He did transactional analysis. So are we the parent, the child, or the adult in the negotiation? And you want to be the person, you want to be the parent to the parent to the adult sometimes. You want to be in control, but you don't want to sound controlling.
Yeah, that's a fine line, very fine line. I know you use like something called stroking and nurturing for that.
Stroking, nurturing, and empathy.
Empathy, that's huge. Empathy, like letting, like you could feel what I'm saying. You care what I'm saying. So okay, well, Claude, what's your offer? I know you said you're a busy man, so am I. What are you thinking you could pay for this piece of land?
Great question. Thanks for asking. How much? What would you're the owner of the and the decision maker of this process, right?
Well, it's me and my wife.
Okay. How's your wife feel about selling this property, if you don't mind me asking?
She's been wanting to get rid of it for years.
Okay. Happy wife, happy life, right? I mean, why you've had it for how long, if you don't mind me asking?
We've had it for almost 10 years now.
Why don't you keep it another 10? It's only going to go up
No
and up.
way. No way. I think now's the time because, it's things are going crazy. You see what's going on in the United States right now. I think we're going to go ahead and get rid of this land.
I'm not sure. So you just woke up one morning and said, let's just sell it because of
Well,
the politics. I'm not sure. Help me out here. I don't understand.
I got your letter and, I
Oh,
figured maybe
okay.
now's a good time. I mean, I'm cleaning out the garage. Kids moved out. I'd like to buy, a new boat. I've been wanting one for years, and wife's been saying get rid of the land, and I can buy a boat. So it just, seemed like bet good timing.
We've got to do a timeout after that because that was beautiful. Okay, if you saw, I was using reverse psychology. We call this redirection sometimes. I was going to you, well, what do you want? You woke up one morning, you want to sell it? Keep it another 10 years. Have you ever heard a salesperson push the prospect
No.
away?
No.
Why am I doing that? Am I crazy,
No.
Claude? Why am I doing
Salespeople,
that?
they seem to get a little bit needy, and it's almost like when you want to buy that land more than they want to sell it, then it's almost repulsive.
Did I, and this is real important, this is a $1 million takeaway for your audience here, right? Get it. If you guys got a pen and paper, write this down. Did I turn you into the salesperson? Have I given a presentation yet?
No. And I felt like I was having to sell you just now. Yeah, you're right.
You just gave me the three. We always look for 3 to 6 needs and greeds or pains, wants, desires, motivation to sum it up. And I kept pushing you away. And the more I pushed you away, what did you do? The more you came back in.
Yeah, I'm thinking about this boat and making my wife happy and getting rid of this land, the needs and the greeds.
So now I give you a score on a 1 through 10. What do you think that, what do you think your score is right now?
Probably
Six.
about a 7.99.
Okay, you're right there. How important is that? You know, and empathy, you mentioned stroking is a pat on the back, a sincere compliment. Nurturing is where we make you emotional. I haven't got to that much yet. And then empathy. Do I know how you feel now? And can I capitalize on that?
I think so.
I tell you what, you wouldn't get this in Wharton School of Business. What we're talking about right now is million-dollar skills.
Yeah.
Okay, this is the way, guys, if you can learn some of the things from this. This is the way you go to the bank and have fun while you're doing it. Okay. We're just totally transparent here. This is the techniques of psychology. Do you think people, let me ask you a question, Brent, before we go back in the role play. Do you think people know what I'm doing while I'm doing it? Do you think they see what I'm doing?
They might, but I doubt it because they probably feel so good talking to you with the like feeling seen, heard, and understood.
Yeah. If I go to you and I say, why don't you keep it for another 10 years? It's a good property. It'll probably go up in value. Do you think they know what I'm doing? Do you really think they pick up on that?
No,
Right.
they're because they're immediately thinking, no, Claude, I need to get rid of it, and here's why.
And we just went from the first step. Guts is a system. Okay. And it's three little steps. And we just did the agenda, setting the rules. Then we went into qualification. You're the owner. You are okay. You and your wife wants to get rid of it. You want a new boat. You got the kids want to, the kids and want to get want you to get rid of it too for or you need it for kids' school or college or something. So all this information that we've gotten, I know we've stopped and goed here, but didn't we get this in just like a couple minutes? We got all this great information. So now we get into the financial qualification. We have to qualify for motivation, most important, decision making. You gave that to me too. And then we have to know the money, the numbers. Okay. And so let's how much what'd you pay for that property? Round numbers. You said you bought it 10 years ago?
Yeah, we probably paid about 50,000. I think we bought it
Okay.
for a little bit too much.
Okay.
We bought
Yeah,
it.
we all do that. Sure. And what would you like to sell it for today?
I was hoping you'd make me an offer.
I don't know. You know, I could do some research and get back to you this afternoon. Give me a ballpark idea what you'd like. Well, how much would you said you paid 50 for it 10 years ago. What do you think it's worth today? Take a guess. 75, 100, 125.
Yeah, it's probably worth about 125.
Okay. Very good. And so what would make you happy today? When you go to, imagine you go to your lovely bride and say, honey, I talked with this good guy. He's straight up and he made me an offer and we're going to get a bunch of money to buy that boat and RV and send the kids to a better private school.
Yeah, I mean, if you paid me 125, she'd be really happy.
Okay. Here's my problem. I can't, if I give you 125, I'm an investor. I have other people I represent and work with. We can't make a profit on 125 for an all cash offer. Would you like all cash or would you like terms? If you'd like all cash, I can close in the next 15 days real fast, but I need a better price. What would be the best price you could give me to do a deal right now?
I mean, could you do 124?
Okay. You know what? I can give you 124 if you're willing to hold the mortgage.
Is that what you mean by terms?
Yeah. It means you said, I believe you said the property's free and clear. Did I hear you correctly?
Yeah, we borrowed some money from her nephew's uncle's sister and finally paid them all off. And yeah, it's free and clear now.
Okay, I'll tell you what, here's my offer. You ready?
Sure.
I'll give you 75, since it's worth 125, I'll give you $75,000 cash and close in 15 days.
Okay.
Or I'll give you $100,000, but you have to hold a note. You have to hold a note, principal only payments for let's say 3 years with a
3 years.
balloon. Yeah. Means you'll get a check every month, which you can use for your payments on your new boat or whatever. And you're just going to be like the bank. I'm just going to send you a check every month, and the property sold for $100,000.
Well, can I think about this?
No.
What if I got to ask my wife?
That's cool. Go ahead.
Oh, you mean right now?
Yeah. Did I stutter?
No.
I'm having fun. I'm over the top today.
Yeah, no, you gotta, sometimes you gotta just shake people a little bit, because I called you, I want to sell the land, and now I'm like wanting to think about it.
But in one phone call, now people are probably asking, how can he make an offer like that for cash? Well, I have the ca see, I got 50,000 under market. I know I can wholesale the property. I can use my own credit to buy the property. I can, and I know I can get terms on it too, where you become the bank and I don't have to go to my capital or my resources, and I can assign it or do whatever I want. I have choices here. Can I, we let's say we did move forward and I didn't, after the fact, later today, I did some due diligence and I discovered the property needs upgrades. It needs repairs. There's a title issue. It's not worth as much as you said. Can I renegotiate with you? Of course.
Absolutely. Yeah, because we're already in the dance.
We're in the dance. Think about this though. This is the takeaway. We're in the dance on the first phone call. Regardless, everybody's so worried about all the due diligence and all that stuff. Man, I want to know, first of all, are you motivated? Are you willing to do price or terms? Are you the decision maker? Can we do the dance? I love that term. I'm going to steal it from you. Can we do that dance right now? Can I get a
Yeah.
commitment from you right now? So let's go back to your objection.
Yeah.
Can I think about it, talk to my wife, all that jazz?
You know what? Yeah, I mean, I'd love to kind of just run this by my wife. I feel like 75,000 could do it with her.
If you can you allow, let's say, what time is it over there by you right now?
It's like 1:54 p.m.
I'll tell you what, crazy busy day. I'm looking at a couple other deals, but I like you and I like this property. I love that location. Can you get back to me by 3 o'clock today? We'll meet on Zoom. You can tell me to get lost, or you can ask me some questions. Your wife is more, be my pleasure to meet with her, and we'll find out if we can move forward today and get all that money in your hand so you can buy the boat, you can send the kids to better school, pay off some bills, and this is all done without paying a real estate commission too. You're done, man. I
Oh
mean,
yeah, her Uncle Bob's been wanting to l l list this property, and I can't stand him. So, you know what,
let's,
Claude? I know what
you
she's
can
gonna
go.
say. I don't. 75,000 will buy the better boat than what I was looking at. Let's do it.
What? I'm sorry.
I said that. Let's just do it.
What about?
75,000 is
But you
better
said
than.
your. What about your wife and everything and Uncle Bob and all these other problems?
You know what? I know she said that she'd take anything if we could get anywhere over 65. She was down.
Sounds good. You're not going to call me later today or tonight and tell me your wife's mad at you or you don't want to do this deal. You're old school. You're a man of your word, aren't you? You're
I'm not.
military. You're a military guy, aren't you?
Yeah. I make decisions. When I make them, I stick to them. So I'm not even going to tell her. I'm honestly just going to get the money and buy the boat, and that's how she's going to know we sold the land.
Okay, isn't she going to have to sign on the contract though?
Oh
Under
yeah, that's right. That's right. That's right.
I'm sorry, my JD came in, my lawyer stuff came in, community property,
That's right. Yeah, I'll tell her tonight. We're good. So, okay, what do we do now? Where do we go here from now?
Okay, boom, back in the role play real quick. Could you do me a, you know what? I've so stroke and nurture. I love doing business with you. You're a straight arrow, and it's going to be great what you do with me. Could you do me one small favor before I go?
Yeah.
I'm going to send you the agreement in the next 15 minutes, DocuSign. Could you get it back to me like in the next half hour, hour? And I will call my attorney. I will open escrow. We'll get this thing going because I want to get you that money as fast as possible for the boat, for the wife, for the kids, for the bills. Can you do me that small favor?
I can do that.
You're a good man. How about your wife? Can she sign on it too?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, she's at work, but I'll if I can give you her email, she can sign it
Can
as
you give me
well.
her email? I'll send it to her too. You give her a call and we're done, man. We can talk a little bit later today if you want, if you have questions. Otherwise, you're getting that money and your problems are over, dude.
I'm excited. I'm gonna go to the boat shop.
What a pleasure to be working with you. Thank you.
My pleasure.
I'm telling you don't know how close this role play. I mean, we were having fun. You don't know how close this
And you
is
know
to.
what's funny? The whole time I just wanted to do a deal on the first call, and that's it. Like, I just wanted to, and I knew what we were doing. So, I mean, not everyone's deal makers like we are, but it's again, you're not going to sell everyone just like that, but you can come darn close And we didn't have to do follow up, none of that. Hey, let's talk later. Or, and then you call me 17 times. Like, I hate that. That's the worst part
about
sales.
Work? Does all that follow up and voicemails and call me in a week and I'll think about it and send me this and that? Does that statistically, how many of those people actually do a deal with you?
Very probably like 1 out of 20 after
yeah.
Because what does that do? That puts me in desperation mode. It puts me in needy mode. It's repulsive.
What's the difference between a self-made millionaire, a one percenter, and everybody else? I call them one percenters
today.
Today, yeah. A sense of urgency. They have authority. They have confidence. How do you get all this stuff? Okay, because deep down inside, you know, I'm a little cream puff, man. Okay, but on the outside, I'm using the system. I practice. I play a role, and this is what we do with our. This is what we do with our students. And this is the million-dollar skill. This is the missing link for people. It really
yeah.
Can we do one quick role play? Just the
let's do
can
it.
We do can, let's do okay. And I can be the I can call you up. You're an investor. Okay.
Okay. Ring. Hello.
Hey, Brent, Claude Diamond. You got a smoking hot deal for you. If you want to hear about it, man, I'm calling everyone on my list today.
Oh yeah, we got to hurry up because the kids are about to walk in. But I'd love to hear it.
Give me 60 seconds. I just got a beautiful piece of property, not far from where you live. It's a 1.25 acre. I just got a contract for $75,000. It has an easy value of $125 to $150. It's in a great, in an expanding area. Make me an offer, man, because I'm working on 3 other deals and I just don't have the time. I just want to turn this over quick.
$85,000. If it's worth $125, I could do $85 on it.
85 is a little, I was thinking 95. Can we split the difference?
I read that book. I read that book.
Split not the difference. You want 75. I want 95. It's worth 125 to 150. How about, I'll tell you what, you're ready to make a commitment, do a contract and do some, and put some money down today or pay for it today.
Yeah, for the right price, for sure.
87.5, it's yours.
Okay, let's do it.
Boom. I just made $12,500 just moving a piece of paper.
Yeah, that's what we call wholesaling land or wholesaling properties, assignment of contract. You don't need banks, you don't need credit, you don't need lenders for this.
Yeah. And people, you know, I gave you a good deal. I had enough room in it so you can still make a profit. And I turned it over a piece of paper. I can do it outside escrow, inside escrow, whatever. I can make it real simple. I can get all cash today. I can get a down payment today. I can give it to the attorney. I have choices. And it's a good, it's just an easy way to do business.
I like it. I like it. I've done a lot of wholesaling of land. You know, that's kind of like the cornerstone of real estate. We got to get things at discounts because that gives us so many more opportunities, so many options, margin of safety, hedge, for whatever you want to call it. You know, that's an infinite return.
Yeah. How about buy and hold? Sometimes you want to hold or develop the land yourself. Okay. Land goes up in value if it's the right price at the right terms, the right location. Sometimes you can hold a piece of land and that's your retirement, man. Yeah. I have literally, and I know you too, have pieces of land that have gone up tenfold. I am not kidding.
There's a few of them. I was telling you about the offer we got on one of them right before we started this. I paid about 160, put about 160 into it, and they're not buying it for the building. They want the land. That's what they want. So, Claude, where can people find out more about you? Well, I know the answer to that. Just guys, go to gutsrhino.com. That's www.guts as in his gut sales method, rhino.com. Guts, G-U-T-S-R.
And we have a special discounted package there.
Yeah. I can't believe that you're offering this for, but that's guts. Rhino, rhino.com. Geez, I almost messed up the spelling of guts rhino.
They're gonna put it in text there anyway.
Yeah, that's right. It's below this video. My I told you right before I got on it, my mind was spinning. We were working 3 deals right before we hit the record button. So today's been a wild day. But I'm excited to, you know, just do more role plays with you, more sales training, more practice. The key to this is practice. Like, you're not going to get this down on one video. It's reading the books that you offer, going to your Monday calls, and then doing the one-on-one calls with you. So how to sell with guts. There you go.
It is, you know, there's so many ways to make money in real estate. The problem is, can you make offers? I talk to people every day. I make offers all the time on it. A lot of people say no, but if you can make it, the word I use, and I don't think anyone says sales and fun in the same sentence, where you're having these just fun, you know, the role plays that you and I are doing, they are so close to what really happens on the phone with people. So close. And if you make, once you get the sales, you get it down, you got the system, and you get comfortable with it. And you, like you said, get it through practice. Everything else falls into place. You start doing deals. Yeah. You just have fun working from home in your own business.
And it's not going to be perfect too, right off the bat. We're never going to be perfect at this. I write down a card after every one of the, well, almost after every one of my calls. I call these my after action reviews. And oh, I missed the agenda on that one. I missed the qualification. I missed the close. I missed the button up or the cigarette close, what you call it. So yeah, it's just keeping track of what you did wrong and what you did right, yeah, and doing better on the next call and making, it's crazy. Eventually you'll have too many land deals or too many real estate deals and you got to say no to most of them. And then you just pick the best.
And we call that a good problem.
Yeah.
Very good problem. And land, what did they say about land? They ain't making the stuff anymore. And it just goes in, you know, if you know how to find the land, do your due diligence, which you teach so brilliantly, right location, and then negotiate price and terms and how to research all that. And then you combine it with the gut sales method. Okay, so you're not wasting a lot of time. You're cutting to the chase. You're having a friendly conversation. You're making offers. Okay, this is the system that can get you to where you want to be in life.
There
it worked
go.
For me. It worked for Brent. It'll work for you folks.
Absolutely. Guys, go to gutsrhino.com. Check out Claude. And Claude, thanks for jumping on. God bless. Thanks for being a go-giver.
Same to you, man. Thank you. Good. I'm sorry we had nothing to talk about today.
Adios.
Bye-bye.